Hello people YouTube, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to some more F1 2017. Currently we are at Russia, at Sochi, so oh wait.
This is what the starting grid looks like for today's race.
Hello and welcome back to F1 2017. I had to cut the F1 logo theme tune and stuff, which is copyrighted. So he did qualify 10th, but we took the grid penalty because of the gearbox.
Fernando Alonso, Wehrlein, and Marcus Ericsson rounds off the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
So let's go. I think there's meant to be rain forecast.
This is looking a good starting position for us.
Yes. We're probably going to have to stretch this strategy out just a touch. I'm probably going to fuel a little bit more. Probably gonna just try and push this first stint out as long as we possibly can. We're probably just gonna have to make do with that, because if the rain comes, I don't know if we're really going to gain anything. We just really need to kind of. We really just need to see where we can go with this strategy. So the last race we did make up, I think, way too many places at the start. We need to kind of hold station a little bit, because at the end of the day we've got a car that's not going to win races. It's not going to be even top 10 probably. So you really just need to kind of just hold station, try and maintain the place we've got. So rain is forecast for the end of the Grand Prix, which is going to make it quite interesting. I'm actually just going to check my settings. I don't know why I'm checking these, but yeah. I just wanted to see if it's still on what medium traction control. I've been trying to see if we can keep the pace up. I feel sometimes I'm good at the start, but I think the AI is a little bit not as difficult at the start. It's like, you know, a couple laps in, we're going to sort of maintain and hold the position. Because I feel that the AI does tend to pick up its pace, and we tend to almost like drop pace, if that makes sense. Here we go. I'm kind of feeling confident for this Grand Prix, but I'm also not. I feel we've actually got quite a lot to lose. Bit of a, maybe not the best start we've ever had. Holy sugar lumps. There's Ericsson down the outside. He's a bit aggressive. Oof. A little bit of contact there. That's a definite corner cut. Wow, what a start. But not necessarily a good start. Well, it's okay, we've held 15th. Kind of a couple of bumps. I don't think we've sustained any damage. Which is good. Have we got some damage? Let's take that corner way too late.
Let's focus there for
the rest of the race. Let's take a little bit. No, fine. Try and get my fuel page up. Palmer's behind us. Now we just really need to concentrate on sort of driving smooth. Trying to keep it as rhythmical as possible. That's a really good corner, but we seem to hold position. We did break that corner, then we came off it. Palmer's goodbye. Scrappy.
Race officials have enabled DRS. DRS is now available. We're considering switching to an alternate strategy to position our joystick to the line. Go back to the front.
Yeah, I'll just keep the current. Cheeky down the inside there, but stuck. I'm actually in the middle of changing my fuel. Bit wide, bit of DRS. sometimes you can get too focused on, oh, I went too fast into that corner and scrubbed a lot of speed. And I was about to say, sometimes you get too focused on who's behind you, and you can lose track on actually just driving. Concentrating on what, like, just getting laps done. I always press the DRS button, sometimes it's just like muscle memory. This is a difficult part of the race now. Because I feel I'm losing track of the guys in front. I feel we can actually lose pace a little bit. Yeah, it's a corner cut. It's warm in there. You really just need to find a groove sometimes. Too much. Again, I know press the button, but I just like to press it just in case. So hard to get that corner, it's, you know, there's not a lot to it elevation wise. It's almost a corner cut. Again, muscle memory. Not bad. Almost took that post out. So we're kind of holding position here. The rain coming, there's a plus spot of rain. So the idea here is just to try and maintain this pace we've got. Oh, that's a bad corner, try and maintain it, stay out as long as we can. Corners can cut up a little bit, and scrap around these corners a little bit. Really, it's getting the switch. This is going to be the toughest part of this race. It's going to be getting the switch between intermediates to John Palmer skins buyers. Palmer's into the pets. I mean, unless he's going for intermediates, why would you really go into the pets? Right, the track's still kind of dry. Off a rich. Start to lose. Oh, losing a little bit of grip here. Broke too late for that corner. Can give up a place. See, I've lost my focus. Holy sugar. Oh, sorry. These tyres are either gone, lost a lot of time here. This is not a good transition between. Oh my goodness! I wouldn't say it was the best pit entry. I couldn't work with those tyres, it was just so bad. So we're on to the intermediates. Whether that's the right decision, I don't know. I think it is going to get wet.
Oh, don't record the.
Right, so we need to go. Probably need to go up a bit easy at this first lap. Tyres are kind of not up to temp. Grip's going to be funny. And that means that Alonso's maybe not going to finish the race. Right, let's pop it into standard. Oh. Again, I don't know how many times I've actually been looking at my display menu and I've missed the break point. Really weird, but we're almost like there's nobody around us. We are so bad at the moment. That was not a good oh sugar. What am I doing? And I'm taking a flight. I'm kind of distracted, but I really don't know what I was doing there. Like, I was looking at the pits, and I was looking at all the cars, and then trying to work out where we're going to be when these cars come out. Conditions are really tricky. That is a bit of a corner cut. Need to be careful of our braking points, because we're kind of braking when it's dry. And it's just way too late. You feel as if you're going too slow, but I mean it's. What does the ones up? Come on. This corner's quite difficult in the wet because you really just almost going to come off the throttle a little bit. My wife's talking, I can hear it. Put me off. Oh, come on, Grosjean, for goodness sake. Difficult. What about a gap here? If we can just maintain that, I'd be happy because we're in P12. Don't take that corner. We have a bit of a gap, and then we just end up losing it in a corner. Right there, oh my goodness. Oh jeez, jeez Louise, what the hell? This is absolutely frightening. What is Alonso doing, man? He's weaving about. I mean, we passed Alonso at that just before the pit entry. What's he doing? Camera in the red just. I'm recording. Sorry about the noise. Right, please. Sorry about that, folks. Oh, here's Hulk coming. Oh, and this is really treacherous. There. Oh come on. Oh no, I'm taking up. I was kinda aware of Hulkenberg there, but I don't know who that was behind them. It's got a different view here. Yeah, was it Massa? No, it was Ocon or Perez. So he just runs into the back. Eventually. Oh come on! Sorry, I don't like taking flashbacks, but people are putting stuff around about me. Final lap. Kvyat's just behind us. Kvyat. That's his name. I want to hold this position. Trigger. I just wasn't thinking. I was too busy looking at my fuel management.
So, another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Lewis Hamilton takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after an excellent result. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Felipe Massa. For me, that was an outstanding performance that drew on every bit of his not unsubstantial experience.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
Thank you.
Welcome to today's... We'll be right back.
I've got something you'll be interested in. Those performance upgrades we discussed after the last race. They're on the car and the data looks promising. Take a look at the details.